Meet John. John commutes daily on the bus, just like 7 million other busy New Yorkers. John also likes to breathe, inhaling oxygen and nitrogen, and exhaling carbon dioxide. In fact, all the commuters on the bus exhale CO2. This theoretical buildup in the cabin could then be collected and pumped through a converter using our catalyst and ultraviolet light. This would produce methane and other hydrocarbons that could be used as a fuel source to power an engine, saving money on gasoline and providing a potential continuous source of energy. Using a conservative average of 4.5 million commuters a day and conversion factors determined from research, calculations were made to determine the amount of miles that could be provided for our hypothetical converter. This process would generate enough energy to provide 300 million extra miles per year for the New York City bus system. In terms of economic savings, by taking an average of $3.50 per gallon, this process generates $130 million each year that would have been previously spent on gasoline. That's a lot of money, even for New York City. This theoretical design could then be utilized by NASA or other space exploration companies as a way to collect and convert excess CO2 produced by astronauts. This converted CO2 would then be a source of usable energy for manned missions and extended stays on the International Space Station.